Hey y'all, a little different for today from my movie review, isn't it? Well, that's because I'm still up in LA, living that Hollywood life, up on the rooftop by the pool at the lowest hotel. I don't even know if you could see, but they got the big Hollywood sign right behind me, and I got all the details for you for last night's movie. Attended the Avengers Endgame red carpet premiere, and let me tell y'all, Y'all, it was everything. Everything. A lot of what we saw in the trailers, as you remember, I feel like they showed us in the trailers what, like, the first maybe 10, 15 minutes of the movie, you know? Remember, you see Hawkeye with his family. That was like at the beginning. You see Captain Marvel come out of nowhere, and her and Thor have that little counter. That was at the beginning. So what we saw in the trailers totally was just like the little piece, a little piece of the beginning of the movie, because there was so much more. So much more, y'all. I don't even know where to begin. We left off the snap, right? The big snap. The movie starts off like the very beginning at the snap time, right? You see that, and then it skips ahead a little bit. And you see that, and then it skips ahead like 5 years. And that's kind of where most of the movie is set. Like within 5 years, kind of after the snap happens, right? It was like, I just want to bring it all together, it was just great. Like, I thought it was the perfect ending. It had the perfect name for the perfect ending of, like, the phase three of Avengers. You know, it brought together, like, it brought together that whole 11-year period, right? It brought together, people were talking to me, it brought together the whole 11-year period, and it had the name for it, Endgame, right? This is the Endgame. This is where it's going to end. It started here, and this is where it's going to end. Well, I guess they're kind of hitting around that Spider-Man, right, is also phase three, but I don't think it should be. I think this ended just perfectly. It was the perfect movie after Infinity War. I felt like 3 hours long. Let me start right there. 3 hours long, everybody was going crazy about that. Oh, this is a 3 hour long movie. There's gonna not be an intermission. There's not gonna be, how am I gonna use the bathroom? Oh, I'm gonna wear a diaper and blah, 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 blah. It didn't feel like it. When it was over, I was like, it's already over? That was 3 hours? It did not, to me, feel like a long 3 hour movie. Now, the beginning was kind of like, I thought it was action-packed most of the way through. Beginning, it kind of leads up to it, you know? So they were like, okay, the snap happened. So this, here's this. And then here's this. And then so for like the first 30 minutes in, I mean, it wasn't so much action. But then after that, I felt like it was non-stop. Like every twist and turns. Oh! And I love how it brought pieces of the old films in the MCU into this. It totally brought like little pieces of the old MCU stuff into this. I'm trying hard not to give like spoilers, because this is definitely a spoiler-free review. You do not want to go in there with spoilers. And even somebody that I went with who loves spoilers and was researching all the spoilers beforehand, she was like, they were wrong. That's what she said. She was like, they said this was in there and that this. She said they were wrong. The Russos, you know, they ain't gonna let a secret out. Even Mark Ruffalo, they ain't gonna let no secret out. I'm gonna tell y'all this, my favorite character in the movie, in this movie, who I think just did an amazing job and had such a twist on the character, was Thor. Thor cracked me up. And Thor's not even that funny, right? Well, Thor Ragnarok, the movie, was funny and stuff, but Thor cracked me up. Y'all, when y'all go see, you'll remember right here, Crazy Amanda said it, Thor. When you see Thor for the first time in Endgame, you're just going to be like, she called it. It was the best. I'm trying not to say too much. He was just amazing. And that's why I said, this is like 5 years after the snap happened. So the people that survived, I mean, it changed them a bit, right? It changed them, their personalities a bit. Things happened. They lost, some of them lost all their friends, all their family. So like that snap changed them a bit. And some, not for the good, right? I mean, you see that in the trailers. Hawkeye, the snap totally turned him into like this Ronin character, right? You saw that in the trailers. So some not so good, and some definitely ones you could fall in love with. So, I mean, there's that. There's cameos. I mean, we have the Stan Lee, you know. They say that was like his last tape one, so I loved his cameo in there. And you even get some other little surprise cameos if you're looking for it. Even little surprise cameos if you're looking for it. So they have that. I'm trying not to say too much. I don't want to ruin it for y'all. You definitely see different periods of time in the movie. Like I said, it starts out here, it flips there, it goes. So you definitely see different periods of time in the movie. You're definitely going to see a lot. There's a lot of action. Someone was like, yeah, I was like, it's action packed. And they were like, I didn't think so. But once it gets into the action, it is action. It is action. And I was on the edge of my seat most of the time. What I love and what Marvel always does for me is that you get the emotional. I mean, you get the happiness. I had, you know, kind of get a little choked up just from the happy moments. I was choked up. I mean, you're totally reliving, you know, the sad moments. So they have that. And I was, tearing up a little over that. But also the laughs. I thought they had, which they do perfectly and mix it all together, is the laughs with the happy, with the sad. I mean, you're on a roller coaster. Marvel, MCU, it always bring you on this roller coaster ride. And you totally get some moments the girl power. There's a scene in there. And it reminded me of when I interviewed Angelina Lilly for Ant-Man and the Wasp. And she was talking about Infinity War. She was talking about Infinity War and that last scene. Remember when like Scarlet Witch is there and Shuri and she was talking about that one scene with them. And she's like, and who was it? It was like something like, was it Scarlet Witch? And then Shuri shows up. She was talking about this one scene. And she said, I just stood up because it was like a girl power scene. And it was the last scene, right? When they're all fighting with Thanos and stuff. And she said, I just stood up in my chair and I screamed, F yeah! Like, because she was just like, girl power, F yeah! She said the real word, F word, but I ain't gonna say that. But anyway, I knew she was there last night. Saw her on the red carpet. At the end of the movie, they brought all the stars up on the stage that were there from the Avengers over the period of the 11 years who made it to the carpet and kind of, you know, gave them a little clap and thank you and speeches. But the one scene I'm talking about with the girl power scene, it made me think, like Evangeline Lilly came to mind because I wanted to do the same thing. When that scene happened, and it was towards the end of the movie, when that scene happened, I wanted to be in like Evangeline Lilly and just jump up, stand up, and just go, yes, yes. It was like a powerful, emotional scene. And I know people go back and forth, like, because they talk about Captain America and, oh, it wasn't, it was more like a SWJ type, you know, character. Not like a real girl power and this and that. This scene it didn't like put down, make men feel like weak. I know that was one of the complaints. Oh, man, makes men feel, they look like the men are the inferior powers and the women are strong. No, it didn't make that happen. And it didn't even like put it in your face like, this is, you know, women or anything like that. But you just see the women come together and fight, and it was just like, whoa. I loved it. I thought it was awesome. And I thought that's, if you want to talk about girl power, and like I said, like Wonder Woman was a great girl power movie for me. I didn't feel it with Captain America, but how they did it in Endgame was the way it should have been done. For those kind of girl power movies. So I was impressed. But yeah, it was great, y'all. I don't think you're gonna have any complaints. I think I need to watch it about 20 more times before I can fully like come to, I know there's just so much I missed and so much I still have to process that I feel like I have to watch it about 20 more times, but it's up there now. It's up there with one of my favorite MCU movies of all time. It's up there. It is up there. I don't know if it's number one, but it's definitely top five for me. So there you have it. And I'm going to have a written review on my blog and enjoy this California sun. Till next time. Bye, y'all.